I have already used at least three terms in React a couple of times so far, which are component, instance or component instance, and React element. In this section, we are going to discuss them. What actually they are, how they associate with each other, and differences between them. This topic is definitely one of the major sources of confusion in React, and you might find lots of misleading and inaccurate information around it in quite a lot of tutorials. And several tutorials don't even discuss React element at all. But here I'm going to make an effort to clear the things up. I want to make a note before proceeding with the discussion. Since these are not the trivial topics to understand, you may probably find this discussion as puzzling, because we are going to dig deeper into React internals, which actually I feel is essential to comprehend and appreciate the beauty of React library and the design principles they adhere to while developing it. Apart from understanding the React concepts, it throws us a lot of insight on design principles that we can actually apply in any of our projects or libraries. Again, I'm not saying it will confuse, but it may do. To understand this topic better, you might want to go through this section a couple of times. Eventually, once you get more familiarized with React, everything will start to make sense. In case if you feel like you are lost in between the discussion, don't sweat it out. Revisit this section when you finished To-Do app, which will be our third application that we are going to build. By that time, you should have enough familiarity with almost all of the React concepts, while simultaneously developing applications make those concepts cement inside your mind. I'm sure you will follow this discussion pretty smoothly if you come back here after To-Do app. To start with, we have already talked about components and a little bit on React element. Anyway, I'll go through it again. I have my shows app open here inside the editor. If you look at any of these components, let's say title, its render method returns a React element, because this JSX will eventually get transpiled to React.createElement method call that returns an object containing some information to create the actual DOM element H3 that shows title on the web page. And that object is what we call as React element. Okay, we'll first try to get the basic idea on React elements using our simple Hello World heading examples. Let me navigate to the slide first. Okay, here we have written code in three different ways to print the same Hello World heading on the web page. First one over here, right at the top, we created a React element by name app, and we passed that React element to render method, which eventually displays the Hello World heading on the web page. Then we went ahead and created functional component here that returns React element. And over here, we are creating an element of our component through JSX and passing it to render method, which will eventually display Hello World heading again on the web page. And finally, we displayed Hello World heading using class component over here, where we defined a special render method, which will again returns JSX or React element. Before we go into the details of why React element exists and try to understand what it really does for us, let's first take a look at what React element contains. A React element is simply a plain JavaScript object describing what's going to appear on the screen. It kind of bookkeeps the information React needs to render components on the web page. Let's take a look at React element that we created directly without using any component. Here we have a React element of type h1 and content or children as hello world stored inside our app variable. And both the forms are identical, as JSX is going to get transpiled to React.createElement call like this. To revise, createElement expects the first argument to be the type of the element. Second argument is props to the element, which in this case is null. And third argument is the children the element contains. Finally, this is the object that will be created and returned by the createElement call. Let's look at its structure. React element has four properties: type, props, key, and ref. I purposely omitted some fields like ref and key from React element structure because we haven't talked about them till now. Let's discuss them in our later sections. Now, the core thing here, app is our React element object describing what to show on the screen. When the render method gets called, our renderer, which is React DOM, looks at this object structure and gets the idea on what to put on the screen by looking at its type and props. When an element's type is a string, it represents a DOM node with a tag name, and props correspond to its attributes. Since its type h1 is put in quotes, it tries to find a match with the actual DOM node. And after finding it, it renders the actual DOM node h1 onto the screen with children or content as hello world mentioned inside our props over here. So that's how we eventually get to see hello world on the screen. Let's try to understand the React element structure with one more example. This time, our app variable contains an React element of type div with style prop applied to it, and it's composed of h1 element with its children to be hello world string. This is again how we can replicate the same without using JSX. Notice that the third argument here, which is a children, is again a React element, since my div here is composed of h1. Okay, so the React element object structure for it would be like this. Here we have a React element of type div that has a style field in its props. And children, this time a React element again with its type as h1 and its children as hello world string. So a React element is just a description that tells React that these are the DOM elements with some attributes and children which needs to be rendered on the web page. If you look closely, every React element keeps its children inside props.children property. That can be a React element or string like hello world, or can be null in case of no children. So one React element can be composed of zero or more children. If we look at our React element object structure from another perspective, it's kind of forming an element tree. Our first example, which just contains hello world text inside h1 tag, would look like this when represented as an element tree. The composition or children property in our React element object helps us to represent our app element like this. The root node or top level node is h1, which is child as hello world string. Similarly, in our previous example, we have a div and it has a children h1 with hello world inside it. So our root node will be div and its child would be h1, which is again a React element, and further it contains hello world string as its child. Let's look at one more example to clear the things up. So we have a React element of type div, which is composed of h1, h2 and a button React element inside it. Let's look at its element tree. Our root node div contains several branches to it. Branches represent the number of children it contains. Our div contains three React elements as its children here. So on its first branch, div contains h1 as its child, which further contains hello world string. Similarly, on the second branch, or as a second child, it contains h2, which further contains hey string as its child. And on its third branch, it contains a button React element that further contains click me text as its child. Notice that this React element tree looks quite similar to our final DOM element tree, but creating DOM elements is costly operation. Whereas React elements are very lightweight objects containing just a few properties. So React elements can be easily created, destroyed or recreated again. Being a JavaScript object, they are easy to traverse also to fetch the information inside them. On to our next slide. Type property helps React to create that particular DOM node mentioned in quotes. And props help React to set attributes to that DOM node. And props.children to maintain composition or element tree. Okay, at the end of the day, using React element, React gets the information on what's the DOM element name using type field, what the attributes to the element are using props field, and what's the composition or children of that element are using children field inside props object. So importantly, React element object has everything that is required by React to create a view and render it on the web page. Now that we have talked about elements of primitive types, let's now talk about functional and class components. We have this functional component greeting, which is just taking props as input and returning a React element div, which is composed of another React element h1. As we have seen, one React element can have several children that can be again React elements. So basically, we are returning a React element tree from our functional component greeting. So our refactored definition of component can be told as, it takes props as input and returns some React element tree as output. Okay. There is no difference between the two forms of greeting component I have mentioned here. All I have done in the second form is, I have stored React element in an app variable and returned that app variable. That's all. So far, we have seen how DOM elements like h1 or div can be represented using React element. But we can also use React element over our user-defined components. I have my user-defined functional component greeting over here, which displays the greeting message sent to it inside props, and also applies color to the greeting message. So when we want to use our greeting component, we just put it inside our JSX and pass props to it. Since all the JSX calls transpile to React.create element, we are essentially creating a React element of type greeting, with props being whatever we mentioned over here inside JSX. Let's look at its React element structure now. We have a type here that is greeting, which is a function that refers to the greeting functional component. Note that it is not mentioned in quotes, unlike our DOM elements or primitive elements. Then we have prop fields color and greeting properly initialized with whatever we mentioned inside JSX or create elements second argument. And finally, we have props.children, which is null, because we didn't mention any children for greeting in JSX or create elements third argument. Okay, let's try to understand now how React is going to render our greeting message onto the screen in the next slide. Since greeting is a functional component, React invokes greeting function and passes props to it. And in return, it spits out a React element of this structure. React parses this object to know what to render on the screen. And while parsing, it sees a div at the top. So it creates an actual DOM node div with attribute color set to blue as mentioned in its props. Then it parses its children, whose type is h1 with content as hello world. So it creates a DOM node h1 inside div with content hello world. After finishing till the bottommost children field, it renders the DOM structure that's been created onto the web page. So this is how React recursively parses our element tree structure starting from the top to bottommost children to create and render the actual DOM nodes onto the screen. Anyway, we are going to discuss more about this later. And with our class component also, same type of React element object will be created and React parses it in the same way, creating and composing the DOM nodes before rendering them onto the screen. One difference being, it creates an instance of our class component, whereas it just invokes or calls the functional component. Okay, to sum up our discussion on React element in a single statement, it's just a plain JavaScript object describing a DOM node or a component and its desired properties, along with the composition using props.children. Okay, now that we understand what a React element is, let's try to understand component and component instance.